Good morning. Today we will discuss the military causes of the revolt of 1857. Some military factors responsible for the revolt of 1857 are ill-treatment of Indian soldiers, General Service Enlistment Act, bleak prospects of promotion, lower salaries, deprivation of allowances, larger proportion of Indians in the army, faulty distribution of troops, poor performance of the British troops. These are some of the military causes responsible for the revolt of 1857. First one, ill-treatment of Indian soldiers. The Indian soldiers helped the British in establishing a colonial empire in India and different parts of the world. Yet the British treated the Indian soldiers very badly. They were poorly paid, badly housed, and the working condition of the Indian soldiers were very poor. They did not allow the Indian soldiers to wear the caste and sectarian marks like beard, turban, tilak, etc. Next one is General Service Enlistment Act. The British Parliament passed the General Service Enlistment Act in 1856. As per this act, they asked the Indian soldiers to do overseas duties. But this was against the sentiments of the Indian soldiers. According to the Hindu tradition, crossing the sea is against the religious beliefs of the Hindus. So Brahmins resented against this act. Third, bleak prospects of promotion. The British always followed the policy of discrimination. They followed it even in military as well. The Indian soldiers could not rise to any higher ranks. All the higher ranks were reserved only for the European soldiers. And an Indian soldier can rise maximum up to the rank of subedar. Next one, lower salaries. The salaries of Indian soldiers were very low. This was too low to support their families. But the European soldiers got higher salaries. The European soldiers drew a salary 8 times more than their Indian counterparts. Next one, deprivation of allowances. Indian soldiers were enjoying some of the free facilities and services in the British army, and the British stopped all these free services. The Post Office Service Act, the Post Office Act of 1854 stopped the free postal service provided to the Indian soldiers. The British asked the Indian soldiers to do their service in faraway places from their homeland. For this, they were not given any extra allowances or compensation. This all increased the financial burden of Indian soldiers. The next reason is larger proportion of Indians in the army. The number of Indian soldiers in the British Indian Army was very high. The number of Indian soldiers were around 2,38,000 in the year 1856. But the number of European soldiers were just 45,322 only. So comparing to the Indian soldiers, comparing to the European soldiers, the number of Indian soldiers were more than 5 times of the European soldiers. Next one, faulty distribution of troops. The British made some mistakes in deploying the European troops. They did not deploy any European soldier in some of the strategically important places like Delhi, Allahabad. There was no European soldier. Next one, poor performance of the British troops. In some of the wars, the performance of the British troops were not satisfactory. For example, the Afghan wars, in the Punjab wars, in the Crimean wars, and in the Shandal rebellion, the performance of the European troops were very poor. So these all were the main military factors responsible for the revolt of 1857. Of these military factors, the first five factors were the main military causes for the revolt of 1857, because these were the real grievances of the Indian soldiers. But the last three factors, they were just an encouragement given to the Indian soldiers in order to turn against the British. These were just an inspiration only. The number of Indian soldiers were very high. That's why it got an inspiration. It gave an inspiration to the Indian soldiers to turn against the British. Then faulty distribution of troops. Some of the places there was no European troops. That's why it gave an inspiration to the Indian soldiers to fight against the British. So actually the last three factors were not the real causes for the revolt of 1857. And the first five factors were the real grievances or the military problems of the soldiers. That's why you pay more attention to the first five factors. And the next cause is immediate cause. There is an immediate cause for the outbreak of the revolt of 1857, and the immediate cause is introduction of Enfield rifle. Enfield rifle is the name of a new rifle introduced by the British. In 1856, the British replaced the old-fashioned musket with a new Enfield rifle. And the loading process in the Enfield rifle was a bit different. The cartridges used in this rifle had to be bitten off by the soldiers before loading it. And there was a rumor spread in the Bengal regiments in January 1857 that the top covering paper of these cartridges were greased, and it was greased with the fat of cow and pig. And this rumor created resentments against the British. The Indian soldiers felt that this may defile the religious beliefs of the Indian people, because cow is a sacred animal for the Hindus and pig is a taboo for the Muslims. So both Hindu and Muslim soldiers were not ready to use this newly introduced Enfield rifle. They protested against the introduction of this rifle, and they refused the use of the newly introduced rifle. And when the British forced the Indians to use this rifle, the Indian soldiers revolted against the British. So thus the introduction of Enfield rifle was the immediate cause for the outbreak of the revolt. That's all about the causes for the revolt of 1857. So we have learned all the four causes for the revolt of 1857. First one was political causes, second social religious causes, third economic causes, and fourth military causes. And the last one, a short term or immediate cause, that is introduction of the Enfield rifle. Now the cause of revolt of 1857, that part is over. So you read the lesson well.